I'll show you the exact clarification questions from my cheat sheet that I use to get offers from companies like Google, Meta, and top trading companies. I was that person, the one deciding your fate while you frantically try to remember if it's log n or n log. But plot twist, a good part of your fate was sealed 1 minute into your typing. Here is the dirty little secret that they do tell you, but you overlook. When a tech employee interviews you, they're essentially scoring you for 4 categories. Clarification questions make up 25% of your total algorithm's interview score. This is Meta's official interview guide, and Google has a similar one. What do we look for? Focus area 1, communication. Are you asking for requirements and clarity when necessary? Or are you just diving into the code? Your coding interview should be a conversation, so don't forget to ask questions. So not asking clarification questions is like not checking your mirrors in your driving test. That's why today we're going to go over the first part, the part with the highest return over investment and the most easily overlooked. Now, imagine your interviewer has verbally given you this prompt. Find 2 numbers from your input that add up to your target. You should ask, what's the input and its type? Is the container an array? List, iterable, iterator? Is the element an int, float, or even string? What should the output be and its type? Should it be the numbers themselves as values? Or should you return the indices of the elements you have picked? Can you give me some more examples? This is an especially powerful question because interviewers are not typically expecting it. So they tend to give away that hidden gacha secret test case they expect you to mess up and wouldn't reveal to you until the very last moment. Let me propose a few test cases and manually run through one. Can I modify the input array or should I treat it as a read-only? This is useful if you want to really bring down the time and space complexities for some of the problems. What are the constraints on the input and expected time space complexity? Correct candidates these days all know that you can derive the time space complexities and the algorithm families you're supposed to use just from the input constraints. For example, if you have 10 to the 6 or 1 million elements, you are actually most likely only supposed to use ON or O log N algorithms. I can also do a video on this topic if you want, so comment constraints in the comment section. So now, I would encourage you to pause for a minute and see what other clarification questions you can come up with, because I know the interviewer is expecting you to do so. And while you're at it, hit the like and subscribe buttons, because my cat's college fund depends on your validation. What if the array is null? What if the input is empty? If you got null for your input, should you return an empty list? Should you return none? Or best of all, raise an exception. Because while you won't throw an exception on LeetCode, that's exactly what you would do in a production work environment. This is what separates inexperienced college grads from senior developers. So now you have a lot of additional information on the question, including an example. However, interviewing is like playing Detroit Become Human. Every pass is treacherous. The most important question is yet to be asked. So what about very large inputs? What about tiny inputs? If you just have a single element, could it possibly be a valid input? It depends on whether you can select the same element twice in your input. And that's the most important question you should ask. For example, if the target is 12, then you can only get 12 by selecting 6 twice. But some interviewers may say that you're allowed to select the same element twice, and some interviewers may say you're not. If you did not come up with that question, you should print out my cheat sheet and hang it by your monitor so that you can see it every day. And they might say, yes, you can select the same element twice, and it has at least 2 elements. Are we good now? Not yet. Because nothing screams amateur than spending 15 minutes on your binary search solution only to realize that you are supposed to use a hash table instead. You should ask, is the input actually sorted? Whenever, in fact, you see the word sorted, ask if it's ascending or descending. Do the sorted elements contain duplicates? And then you're given additional information that is sorting in ascending order. So now we have some questions that separate the pros from everybody else. If there are multiple valid answers, which one should I return? Since you will return indices, it's possible that you get, say, 2s in your input. And hence, to get the target 6, you can choose either the first 2 or the second 2. And the interviewer might ask you to, say, return maybe the smallest indices in your answer. What order should output be in? And then here are also some additional questions that I go over in my mind, even though they are not applicable to this specific question. What if everything is the same? What if everything is unique? And specifically for graph questions, we also have some interesting edge cases. Could there be cycles? What about isolated nodes? Isolated nodes trip out candidates so frequently because they not only change the correctness of your solution, but also the time and space complexities. So please be sure to keep those in mind. And here it is, ta-da! The clarification question cheatsheet from my notes. If this video just saved your ass in your next coding interview, please click that subscribe and like buttons, because you don't want to miss future algorithm interview tips that will make you go potentially from reject to strong hire. And I'm also organizing the algorithm part of my cheat sheet, so stay tuned. Comment any feedback or topics you would like me to explore next. Peace.